beautiful. Andrea in Salt Lake City.
Hey, afternoon, everybody. Hey.
Good afternoon. Could you, Andrea, have a relationship or a marriage with someone that you were polar opposite with politically?
You know what? I'm going to take the principle of beggars can't be choosers and apply it to that question. So, I can't really be that discriminating, to
Maybe
be honest.
Maybe you don't think you could marry a chooser?
Yeah, well, see, what you're delightfully self-deprecating, but I would actually reframe that as open-mindedness and open-heartedness and not being a closed-down dummy. So I would give yourself credit rather than, yeah. I mean, unless you're, like, really ugly. I have no idea what you look like, so, you know.
Actually, I just must not have gotten to that page of your book just yet. So maybe,
she's
maybe
reading
tonight.
It.
Well, so what do you guys think of this? Which is more of a barrier to a marriage? Someone marrying someone of a different religion. I'm assuming if you're, I'm talking about believers. Like if you're a believing or a practicing, you know, Christian, then you know, and a Muslim or a Hindu or something like that. Religion. Culture, like marrying a foreigner whose first language, you know, you marry someone from Paraguay, or politics.
I would put them in the order of religion and then politics second, because now it's politics versus a religion, because the left is a religion. It's based on faith.
Uh-huh.
And so, and then finally, I don't think culture is necessarily a barrier at all.
Okay, so the biggest barrier, religion, second.
Religion two.
Yeah, religion two, politics. What do you think, Mandy?
I can't get over that last caller who was reading my book and I never let her ask her question.
Oh, yeah, no, she's still here. Andrea, what's your question?
I didn't prepare.
hilarious.
I was going to say, you were giving me some advice, and I was wanting to know what page that showed up on in the book and what page that might be on.
Oh, about being that what you had said was open-heartedness rather than that beggars can't be choosers?
Right.
That would be page 136, and that would be the fourth paragraph down. I don't know if I said those exact words, but that is definitely like a very big thing for me, is the idea of reframing, because a lot of times you can just be so hard on yourself and then all you do is just live this kind of self-fulfilling prophecy. And for me, that's kind of one of the messages of the book is, oh, I'm unwifeable, I'm unlovable, I'm unworthy. And then...
Mandy, do you mind if I interject?
No, please read that paragraph. I'm dying to know what it is.
No, it's good. We got a break.
I
just want to say thanks for buying the book. Hope you're enjoying
it. Thank you so much. I appreciate that.
Thank you, Andrew.